Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois. With Lori Cease.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting has given me all the necessary tools and resources to take my personal dream to become a radio DJ to the next level. Not only am I the program director of the edgeonair.com, where you can hear the greatest music you've never heard, but I am also an on-air talent at 96.7 The Eagle, classic rock that really rocks. Again, without ICB, none of this could have been possible. And I would like to accredit all my success because of my start here at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
Hey, it's your boy Johnny K. I'm here with my partner Patrick. Say hi, Patrick.
Hi, Patrick.
And don't forget to tune into us each week for the Sunday Sports Show.
Yes, it's every Saturday on Sports Town Chicago.
Whoa.
What?
No, Sunday.
I thought we were on Saturday.
No, man, Sunday Sports Show.
Oh, I guess I never thought of it that way.
Oh, anyway, don't forget to tune into us each Sunday from 10 a.m. to noon, the Sunday Sports Show, only on SportsTownChicago.com.
What are we going to do about football season?
Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportsTownChicago.com, Bailey and Banks host Fallout MMA, where you can hear them talk about the top female MMA fighters and follow the UFC very closely. Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportsTownChicago.com, Fallout MMA, Bailey and Banks. Come check out the aftermath.
SportsTownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportsTownChicago.com or dial 630-916-1700.
SportsTownChicago.com is now bringing you behind the scenes with contestants from NBC's The Biggest Loser.
Holy cow!
Check out SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser to download exclusive interviews with past contestants and winners.
Why are we so blessed?
Listen as they talk dieting, sports, hobbies, and life after The Biggest Loser. So log on to SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser now.
God bless the internet.
SportsTownChicago.com
in a league of our own.
Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Jarrell Jernigan.
At ICB, the most important lesson that I learned was that you get what you put into it. The days that you're at school, you have class for only 4 hours, and that doesn't do any justice. You actually have to put forward the time, grab an internship. You can't learn anything unless you're actually there at a real station learning what goes on. I'm currently at Cumulus Broadcasting, currently part-timer, helping out with anything between promotions to production to even on air at times. And I couldn't have done that without the help of ICB and without an internship from Cumulus Broadcasting, 97ZOK.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportsTownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportsTownChicago.com or dial 630-916-1700.
Hello, Chicago!
SportsTownChicago.com is now your home for the Chicago Mustangs.
I don't believe you. You must be lying.
No, just keep it tuned to SportsTownChicago.com as the Mustangs try to rise to the top of the Mid-States Football League.
I want to go higher.
With hard-hitting action and big plays all over the field, the Chicago Mustangs are the perfect start to your football season.
Football!
Go to SportsTownChicago.com/ShyMustangs for all the action.
Can't wait!
SportsTownChicago.com. We're in a league of our own.
breaking down the world of hockey from high school to the pros, covering every NHL team and getting into the crease with all the news and controversies. Following the Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks and the AHL powerhouse Chicago Wolves, giving you the latest info on the AHL and providing you with our complete access to the Wolves. Throw down your gloves, remove that face shield, and score off with us on the Lamplighters. If you can't light the lamp, get back into the box. Lamplighters, every Wednesday from 5 to 7 with Chris Lobosco and Adam Osgood on SportstownChicago.com.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Lori Cease.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting has given me all the necessary tools and resources to take my personal dreams to become a radio DJ to the next level. Not only am I the program director of the EdgeOnAir.com, where you can hear the greatest music you've never heard, but I am also an on-air talent at 96.7 The Eagle, classic rock that really rocks. Again, without ICB, none of this could have been possible. And I would like to credit all my success because of my start here at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
You've just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportsTownChicago.com, the only place where you can talk Pokemon with the Pokemaster. Bringing you all the pressing topics brought to you by SportsTownChicago.com.
Did you see it's called a strikeout? Interesting. Yeah. I'll try one more. Why not? Pretty easy. Yeah. Oh, come on! Strike out the competition on SportsTownChicago.com.
Hello and welcome one, welcome all, high school volleyball. Quick, whoa! The first dump of the evening, Colleen Smith!
Pete, it's finally here. That makes his night.
Woohoo! Thunderheart! And by the power and hammer of Thor, she brings it down!
Gendra sends it over the net, return left side, Eadsfall. Set, far side, Collins sends it over, Burke with a good dig. Pushing it back, Swiger, tipping it two-hand over the net, return, O'Neill, near side. O'Neill, is she able to bring it down? Good one-hand punch by Andrew. Swiger sends up, far side, sending it back, row return by Murphy. Beautiful rally here at Marist. Double person block, O'Neill keeps the left-hand side, going back, slide, good two-person block again. They found O'Neill's number in Eadsfall. Sends it, far side, Murphy, set up by Curran, goes back row, pushes it down, Eadsfall again with a diving dig. Pushing it down, keeping it is Lauren Zielinski. That was a rally of the ages. Ice, ice, baby for that one. Forever too cold, too cold. My God, it's like Ivan Drago.
I must break you.
And she gets the clap, 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 stomp, stomp, clap, 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 stomp. Ayy. Pashke, back to Anko. Anko tips it over, Netzinga. Smith, far side, Lemberti. Lemberti down. Lemberti kill. And that's all she wrote. SportsTownChicago.com.
Booms, I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly. When I play a dope melody, anything less than the best is a felony.
And welcome one. Welcome all to the Go South Sports Series live here on SportsTownChicago.com. We are in a league of our own, Dr. Pete, alongside Kyle Griff, Twitter account KGriff89, as the colors are being presented on the far side of the court down here in DuPont, Illinois. Kyle, we have finally made it. We have finally gone south.
Yeah, we are down south, man. It's fun, and it's definitely been an experience coming into this little towns down here, and you never know what you're going to get, but we've met some nice people, and getting ready for some exciting volleyball.
Yeah, we are absolutely, I'd like to say, in a league of our own today, as we have the Cahokia Comanches taking on the DuPont Tigers. Kyle, we got to talk before the game to Mr. Jamie Carter, the regional sports editor for one of the local newspapers down here, and really helped us, giving us a better background on both of these teams. Some standout players on both teams. We'll get to that in a minute. But it's just great to be in an atmosphere where this is what's going on tonight in this town. 4,000 people live in Dupo. They are here to see some volleyball. Cahokia, right down the road. Separate conferences, but still a rivalry because of the proximity.
Yeah, nonetheless, it's literally you drive down one street, which we drove down, and you're there. So it's the natural rivalry between the two schools. 5 minutes separate them, so it's inevitable. You've got a much smaller school in Dupo, like you said, and the town itself only holds 4,000 people, but Cahokia and Dupo is definitely a rivalry because of the proximities of the schools, and it should be fun for the girls and us too.
Yeah, and got to give a quick shout out to our drive buddy himself, part of the WISC TV network. So yes, folks, make sure you go to the website and check out all the video highlights. Mr. Curtis Sahe is down here. Great that we got video the whole week.
Yeah, absolutely. We definitely needed the video. I don't think many people would believe us if we didn't have the video. So, but no, it's great to have the video, especially not only for us but for the girls themselves, because you don't get this kind of exposure down in the southern parts of the state.
No, you don't. Just to go through some of the players, some of the starters on both teams. On the far side, we have for the Cahokia Comanches, we have number 2 Essie Campbell, number 35 Darielle Ivy. Player to watch out for, might I add, says Mr. Carter. Number 17, Mitranza Moffitt. We have number 3, Michaela Dew. Number 28, on the court, we have Rancha Desdemore. And we have number 6, and number 6 being Demetrius Brown. They're going to be the starters there for the Cahokia Comanches going far to near. On the court wearing blue jerseys with white trim and white numbers. For the home Tigers, we are having Sierra Amsden, 5'5 senior. We're going to have Lydia Edwards, a 5'6 junior. Player to watch out for the Tigers, a 5'7 junior, Shannon Hood. Only player of the team right now that plays club ball. But again, talking to Mr. Carter before the game, he said, definite candidate possibly for our 2011 Futures game. So really something to keep in mind as we might see talent on both sides of the court today that may impact our All-Star weekend.
And that was the whole point of coming down here for this Go South Sports Series, Pete. We wanted to come down and see the prospects out this way for the All-Star game. And you know, maybe for some coaches around the area who check us out. Because these girls don't really get to see the talent level up north except for when it gets closer to the championship weekend. And, you know, it's good for us to see it as well since we'll be covering it.
Yeah, a quick shout-out, too, to assistant coach Matt Carpenter and head coach Jenna Kramer. She was just a gem helping us come down here, scheduling this game, being here tonight, working with her to make this game happen. And definite, we got to give the shouts where shouts are due.
Shout out to the t-shirt people, because we got t-shirt time. And that is our goal this whole time out here.
Yeah. Can we get a t-shirt from every high school that we visit? But again, we're here for a great time. We're not here for a long time. No liberos for either team. Let it be noted, there is no libero play for either team. Not a big thing in the southern part of the state, but Edwards is underway, and we go far to near, and a quick two-hand tip over the top by Moffitt, picked up easily, and two-hand set underneath, not able to get it over the net, is going to be number 10 for the home Tigers, Kate Donald.
Yeah, unfortunately right there, she got a little bit confused on which way it was going and just caught it off the edge of her wrist and sent it into the net.
Back to serve now is going to be number 2, Campbell. Right hand, set serve, able to clear the net. Picked up cleanly by Hood, send it over the net. She's playing the middle block position. Goes outside, right hand tip over the top. And Dupo not able to get there in time. Cahokia gets a point, 2-0, they lead.
Yeah, got sucked in a little bit too close to the 10-foot line. And Hood was a little bit too close up to the net for that play. And they stumped it over the top.
Yeah, again, two players we look out for. Again, Hood and Ivy, the two players we were told to look out for. But we're here to see everybody, as is two great teams, good southern part of the state rivalry. Good pickup there by Hood. Sets across the middle. Spike down over the top of the Nesby by Moffitt. Hood sets up to the outside. Spike attempt there by Amsden. Able to be cleared cleanly. Spike over the top. Big spike. Big kill there. I'm trying to get the number there. That was number 3 on the play. Michaela Dew, another player we were told to look out for, and she is definitely making a statement early on.
That she is, Pete, and puts the hammer through the double block.
Spike over to the top of the net, picked up, not picked up cleanly by number 11, Kelsey Ragsdale, the 5'3 senior. And folks, we've had a lot of great interviews before the game. Make sure you check out the website, sportstownchicago.com/go south, where you can get those exclusive interviews from some of the players of the Tigers before the game. Back to serve now with a 4-0 lead for the Comanches. Right hand over the top is going to be by Campbell. Picked up cleanly by Hood. Set near side. Hood sends it down, but sending it a bit too far is going to be Shannon Hood, the 5'7 junior. 5-0 early rally continuing on for the Comanches.
Yeah, a little bit too far out of what she likes, as we were told by one of her teammates, that she likes to set a little bit closer to the net, and it was a little bit too far out for her.
Back to serve and going for another point, but a net violation on the service error. Essie Campbell sends that one into the net. We are at 5-1. That could be the break that the home Tigers needed.
That's definitely what you need in a situation like that, so you don't have to call a timeout. You were down 5-0. Get that point back and get on a roll.
Sierra Amsden able to clear the net with the set serve. Sets up near side. Spike down off the double block. Good pickup there by Edwards. Spike over to the top of the net with the right hand is going to be by Donald. But that one goes out of bounds, sending a bit too far, and Cahokia gets another point, but again, seeing the power of Dew at the net.
Definitely seeing the power, but the height for Dupo is hurting them a little bit because they're not very tall, so it's really affecting their game.
Ivy over the top of the net, sets near side. Ivy two-hand drops it over the top. Dot able to pick it up, sends it over with the right hand. It's going to be by Wilson. Sets near side, hits the antenna. Number 17 there, Moffitt. For Cahokia, and point goes to the home Tigers.
Yeah, once again, you take what you can get, it, whether it's a service error or anything, ball handling errors, you take what you can get right now, and you don't want Cahokia to get on a run like they were, because it'll just put you in a world of trouble.
Sissy Brown checks into the game now, a serve specialist, right hand able to clear the net, picked up back row by 23 Grissom. Sends over to the far side, and another spike, another kill there. Michaela Doo. 7-2.
She's definitely putting a hurting on them right now, and it's unfortunate because Dupo has no answer for them whatsoever.
Not a lot of height for Dupo. We have 5-7 in Keys and Hood and Donald. Right now, not able to stop the Dew attack. Good dig down low. Spike over the top. Picked up again by Amsden. Sets to the near side. Hood over the top of the net. Good dig from the back row there by Moffitt. Sets up far side. Dew over the top. Every day, she's shuffling. Point again for the visiting Comanches.
Yep, once again, Pete, she's showing her skills in exposing Dupo's defense and putting it in a position where they're not.
Back to serve and sending it over the net cleanly. Oh, I thought it was going to hit the net. It wasn't. Either way, it's 8-3. Point goes to Dupo.
Yep. Take what you can get.
Back to serve now, Shannon Hood, set serve, good serve over to the top of the net, clears at that time, Grissom goes far side, and able to pick it up is Dew. Sets up across the far side of the court, two-hand back bump is going to be by Brown, going to the far side with a good move, but missing the spike on that one, number 13, Tyree Hall, 8-4, good little rally now for the home Tigers.
Definitely a good rally, something that they needed.
Right hand serve again. Hood able to drop that over the top. Picked up two hand set is going to be by Densmore. Setting over the top of the net, but lift called there on number 11, Kelsey Ragsdale. We're back to a 5-point lead, 9-4.
Unfortunately, that's what happened when the ball has come screaming at you, and there's nothing you can really do but lift it to get it out of there.
Jump serve and going into the net, but good attempt there by Michaela Dew. Again, bit of a difference here, Kyle, through talking with Mr. Carter. Dupo 1A team, Cahokia a 3A team. So it just shows a bit of a difference when we relate it back to our friends up north. 5-10 is your score on a service error by Dupo. The likes of Scales Mound would play a Dupo. The likes of a Wheaton St. Francis would be playing a Cahokia team. So the fact that Dupo is doing a very good job peaking it right now only to 5-10 really is showing us something here today.
Definitely is. It's tough going up against schools with more experience in playing tougher schools. So, and it's only going to make Dupo better, in considering that there's such a young team playing a tougher team in the area.
Densmore over to the top of the net, gets the ace, goes for another one, picked up that time by Hood. Goes back to Hood at the 10-foot line, sends it over, two-hand, good set. goes near side, spike over the top of the net, picked up cleanly by Ragsdale. Sets up to the outside, set, hit by Donald. Good bump back row there by Densmore. Sets up outside, spiking it over. Good pick up on the near side is going to be by Edwards. Two hands set over the top is going to be Ragsdale. Resetting up, goes near side with the length of it. Picked up again there by Edwards. Sets up to the net, Dodd or Hood over the top of the net. We're still keeping it alive. Going to the far side there is going to be two Campbell. Good dig down low. Edwards sends it back to the middle. Miscommunication there. I'm not falling out of my chair. And 12-5, timeout called by Coach Kramer. We'll take that timeout win, and a quick shout-out, Brian Dingus and Kevin Hayes, the two officials for today's game. We'll take a quick timeout when we come back. Continuation of set one here at DuPont High School on SportsTownChicago.com.
SportsTownChicago.com is now bringing you behind the scenes with contestants from NBC's The Biggest Loser.
Holy cow!
Check out SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser to download exclusive interviews with past contestants and winners.
Why are we so blessed?
Listen as they talk dieting, sports, hobbies, and life after The Biggest Loser. So log on to SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser now.
God bless the internet.
SportsTownChicago.com
in a league of our own.
106 miles to Chicago. We got a full tank of gas, half a pack of cigarettes. It's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses. Hit it.
Where Chicago sports live, SportsTownChicago.com.
And we're back, SportsTownChicago.com. Serve over the net, 12-5 deficit. Keeping alive there is good play by Donald on the side bump. Going far side down, Ivy sends it over far, but picking up cleanly back right corner is going to be Edwards. Hood running into the net, not able to get it. Not a clean set there by Sissy Brown, 13-5.
Yeah, unfortunately, it wasn't a clean set, so Shannon Hood couldn't really get underneath it enough to get it over the net.
Densmore over the net, and a ace there by Densmore as the junior 5'6", Lydia Edwards, not able to get underneath that one, 14-5. The Comanches are on a roll.
That they are, Pete, and DuPont has no answer right now.
Back to serve again is going to be Densmore. Right-hand set, serve over the top of the net, picked up cleanly, Donald. Bump there, far side by Sissy Brown, two-hat sign, bump by Amsden. Set to the far side, good spike over the top. Net play, and joust won by number 17, Shannon Hood. You shall not pass.
Yeah, that was Shannon showing her her strength and her power and showing why she's one of the best players for DuPont.
14-6, your score. Back to serve the senior 5'3", Kelsey Ragsdale. Right hand, good set serve over the net, picked up back row by Densmore. Back serve there by Dew, two hand over the top is going to be by Campbell. Resetting the attack, going far side, right hand spike down is going to be by Wilson. She falls down as Edwards able to pick it up. Bump to the far side as Amsden able to send it down. Good dig back row. Net play there by Edwards. Keeping it alive and sending it far is going to be Campbell. Two hand over the top of the net, keeping it alive. Densmore again sets up Dew, spike down. Good pickup down low. Donald goes near side. Amsden down. Tool block. Tool kill. Kay Griff.
Screwdriver.
14-7.
Yeah, right there. Beautiful rally back and forth and got the point that they needed and hopefully get them some confidence back in this game.
Back to serve now. Again, the senior leader, Kelsey Ragsdale. Right hand, set serve. Good job clearing the net and playing it incorrectly. Michaela Dew, and 14-8 is your score now. Here we go. A bit of a rally for the home Tigers. Back to serve now. Again, it's going to be Ragsdale. Bounces a few times. 14-8, your score. Right hand, set serve. Clears the top of the net. Do not able to get that one. Another ace. Pull that one out of the sleeve. They trail again only by 5.
Senior leadership. I know she's, you know, she's a leader on this team, and she's showing you right now. She's stepping up and doing what she has to do to get her team back in.
Ragsdale set serve yet again over the top of the net. Oh, but it just goes out of bounds. She was trying to direct it there. But again, good rally for the home Tigers. 15-9 now your score.
Definitely a good rally. Getting them back in a position where it's easier to come back from.
Hall back to serve. Right hand set serve. Picked up cleanly by Donald. Set to the far side. Spike over the top is Wilson. Campbell goes to the near side. Left hand not able to get over the net is Ivy. 15-10. Here come the Tigers again with Edwards back to serve.
Yeah, going for the quick tip attempt and and she just got a little bit too far ahead of herself and sent it into the net.
We are again on SportsTownChicago.com in a league of our own, part of the WISC Radio Network. Edwards back to serve. Right hand able to clear the net. And, oh, good dig down low, saying it far side, tipped over with the right hand, is going to be by Denzimore. Spike down. Does it stay in bounds? It stays in bounds! Shannon Hood! Baby, I like it. The way you move across the floor. 15-11.
Yeah, she did what she told us she was going to do. She painted them corners and using her athletic abilities.
And shoe tying on the far side of the court by Mitanisha Moffitt. Back to serve now with only a four-point deficit is Edwards. Right hand able to clear the net. Good pickup far side. Hits off the roof. Back dump attempt, and that one stays in bounds. Griff, we have our first dump of the day, 16-11.
Yeah, great dump right there, and playing it off the roof and not knowing exactly what it's going to do. And she dumped it over the top and put it in a position where they couldn't get a hold of it.
Back to serve and sending it a bit too far in the serve is going to be Essie Campbell. 16-12, only a four-point deficit for the home Tigers.
They need to capitalize on these mistakes. And they're only down by four, but the mistakes are manageable, and you just have to come back from them.
Checking into the game now, Rachel Ostertag, a 5'4 sophomore, seeing some playing times as a lift call there on number two, Essie Campbell. They trail by three.
Once again, mistakes are what's going to kill you, and you can see it right now for Cahokia that they're letting Dupo back in by their mistakes.
Amsden back to serve, right hand set serve. Clears the net, picked up cleanly by Moffitt on the far side. Big left hand over the top. She saw the double block coming. Smart play there, Michaela Dew, 17-13.
Definitely a smart play. You don't see that very often in the rankings of Kyle or high school where they just go around the double blocks.
Ivy sends it over. Ostertag able to pick it up cleanly. Hood spikes it to the far side. Two players almost running into each other, but they don't. But it's still, nobody can pick up the bump. Back to 3 points, 17-14. And substitution coming into the game now, number four, Sissy Brown coming out of the game. Kirsten Wilson, again, if anybody wants to see a fun video, SportsTownChicago.com, our substitution video starring our very own Kyle Griffin.
Yeah, that's me.
Sissy Brown now back to serve, 17-14 your score, right hand set serve. And a tape ace on that one. Tape kill, 17-15. They trail by two. Timeout needed. Coach Kramer jumps up. Really quickly, this timeout first brought to you by Team Dow Wellness. If you are looking for a way to have weight loss management, check out teamdowwellness.com or email at info@teamdowwellness.com for more information. Taking a quick timeout here. Two-point deficit for Dupo on SportsTownChicago.com.
Do you see it's called a strikeout? Interesting. I'll try one more. Why not? Pretty easy.
Oh, come on!
Striking out the competition on SportsTownChicago.com.
Oh, you can tell by the way I use my walk. I'm a woman's man. No time to talk. The music loud, and we're back playing here, 17-15. Your score, two-point deficit. Serve specialist Sissy Brown able to clear the net. Good pickup down low there by Grissom. I haven't said her name in a while. Dew sends it over the net. Hood tips it with the left hand. Still alive by the Comanches. Far side, right hand over. No lift there on Armsden. Keep it alive is number four, Brown. Again, Brown, an impact player so far. Quick set to the near side, spike down, just tips it over the top. Good play there by Ronsha Denzelmore. Smart play, two out of the past 3 points, Kyle, tipping it over the approaching block.
Yeah, Dupo's showing the double block a little bit too soon. You kind of want to delay it, and that's one of the reasons why that Cahokia is able to tip it over the top so quickly and so easily.
Moffitt back to serve, right hand set serve, clears it, picked up by Ostertag. Set near side, Brown, right hand over the top by Ragsdale, dig down low there by Grissom. Right hand over the top, picked up cleanly there by Hood. Set up back to Hood, over the block, still alive is the Comanches. Sets up far side, Dew down, Dew kill. Oh, 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 oh my gosh. 19-15. Oh, 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 oh my God.
All right, Ursher.
Back to serve, Moffitt clears the net, picked up cleanly by Ragsdale. Sets to the near side, right hand over by Donald. Reset the attack for the Comanches. Far side, Dew down. Ostertag able to pick it up. Good dig underneath by Ragsdale. But miscommunication by Donald and Amsden makes it 25-15. What a beautiful dig, though, on the outside by Ragsdale.
Definitely a beautiful dig. And the miscommunication is something you see with teams who are so young and inexperienced with each other, and that's what's going on right now.
And that one goes out of bounds. Good job on missing it on that one. 16-20, they're back to a four-point deficit.
Yeah, good thing she did miss it there, Pete, because she would have hit that, and who knows what would have happened, and it wouldn't have gotten the point.
Hood back to serve now with a four-point deficit. Good set, right-hand set, serve over the top. Misplayed there, but able to be kept alive. Right-hand over the top by Denzimore. Sissy Brown sets back near side. Two-hand over the block is Donald, still alive as Dew able to keep it in. Two-hand sends it far, Edwards. Bump near side, going for the kill attempt. Two-hand side set there by Dew. Good dig down, Hood, right-hand over the top by Donald. Sends it far. Oh, but it just goes out of bounds. Point goes to the visiting Cahokias, 21-16.
Good rally set up there by Dupo, but they just have to be confident in themselves and get it down.
Dew, good jump serve over the top, picked up cleanly. Edwards goes near side. Two-hand is Donald sending it over with a set. Reset to the far side for the Comanches over the top. Edwards and Ragsdale not able to dig underneath that one. She hit the ground pretty hard on that one. 21-16.
Yeah, she landed square on her stomach right there going for that one. It just goes to show you how tough these girls are in taking falls and beads and bruises on their body for anything.
That's a belly flop on the floorboards. Directional kill there and hitting the table. Unbelievable ace out of the sleeve, Michaela Dew. And we got another timeout. This timeout, hey, volleyball fans, brought to you by Sports Performance, the Great Lakes Center in Aurora. You ever want to make your way to the mecca of volleyball in the great state of Illinois, go to GreatLakeCenter.com for more information. We'll be back 23-16 on SportsTownChicago.com.
Hey, it's your boy Johnny K. I'm here with my partner Patrick. Say hi, Patrick.
Hi, Patrick.
And don't forget to tune into us each week for the Sunday Sports Show.
Yes, it's every Saturday on SportsTown Chicago.
Whoa.
What?
No, Sunday.
I thought we were on Saturday.
No, man, Sunday Sports Show.
Oh, I guess I never thought of it that way.
Anyway, don't forget to tune into us each Sunday from 10 a.m. to noon, the Sunday Sports Show, only on SportsTownChicago.com.
What are we going to do about football season?
On SportsTownChicago.com.
And Dew serve over the net, picked up, not able to be picked up cleanly by Sierra Amsden. We are now at set point, 24-16.
Unfortunately, right there, the confusion on whether to bump or set is what hurt her right there and puts him at games.
Dew, another big jump serve, picked up down low, Hood, right hand over the top, point down, point kill by Denzimore. And that's going to be how the first set ends here today. 25-16 is the way this first one's going to end. Can the hometown Tigers bounce back against the proximity rival Comanches? Well, we'll find out as we come back on SportsTownChicago.com.
SportsTownChicago.com is now bringing you behind the scenes with contestants from NBC's The Biggest Loser.
Holy cow!
Check out SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser to download exclusive interviews with past contestants and winners.
Why are we so blessed?
Listen as they talk dieting, sports, hobbies, and life after The Biggest Loser. So log on to SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser now.
God bless the internet.
SportsTownChicago.com.
In a league of our own.
If Chicago baseball's got you down and you're looking for hard-hitting football this summer, then head to SportsTownChicago.com for all the action of the Northwest Illinois Wildcats.
I like this kind of party!
Every Saturday, the Wildcats try to claw their way to victory in the Great Midwest Football League. And for all the sound and latest news on the Wildcats, go to SportsTownChicago.com/Wildcats.
Bang it, baby!
SportsTownChicago.com and the Northwest Illinois Wildcats. We're in a league of our own.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Mike Kurtz.
How did ICB help me? Let's just say this one simple thing. Take advantage of everything, from studio time to everything that they have, all the equipment that's available to you. Go out, get your internship. This is what I did. I put everything in one pile, went out, got my internship, got hired on part-time before I even graduated ICB. Within 2 months after graduation, I was hired on full-time in the production department. Guess what? Now I got the best of both worlds. Monday through Friday, it's production. Every Saturday night, I have my own show on air at 96.7 The Eagle. Classic rock. That really rocks.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
In Illinois, more than 300,000 students compete in interscholastic programs taking place in classrooms, auditoriums, gymnasiums, city parks, and stadiums. Students with extracurricular activities tend to have higher grade point averages, better attendance, lower dropout rates, and fewer discipline problems. IHSA sponsors 35 programs that enrich the educational experience and shape the lives of young people in a positive way. Support the schools, teachers, coaches, sponsors, and students who take part in activities sponsored by the Illinois High School Association.
They call me King Ho Copy. They call me King Ho Copy.
And we are back on SportsTownChicago.com with a serve over to the top. Starting the second set by Essie Campbell. Goes to the near side, right hand over the top by Donald. Sets up, good set there across the middle. Sending it down is Moffitt. Picked up cleanly for Cahokia, and not able to pick it up cleanly is going to be Sierra Amsden. Again, miscommunication, Kyle. Hurt him in the first one. Not remedied right now in the start of the second set.
Definitely not remedied yet. They need to be able to communicate in order for this to work.
Campbell sends it over the top. Picked up cleanly on the far side. Picked up cleanly that time. A lot of clean pickups here in this second set. Spike down. Oh, good pickup there from potential all-star to potential all-star as we have Dew going over to Hood. Sends over to the far side. Dew down. And does it stay in? It does not stay in. Point goes to the visiting Tigers.
Yeah, that right there is what you need. The communication was there for that point. And you need the bench in it. You need the crowd in it. You need all your team in it because they need to be able to know what's going out the back.
Hood, is it stay in? It does stay in. Clap, 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 stomp, stomp, clap, clap, spin, stomp, clap, fist pump, ace.
That's what they need. They need to get these quick points and get a little bit of a lead against this Cahokia team just so... because they can sustain what Cahokia does. They just cannot force mistakes upon themselves.
Edwards with a right hand. Set serve. Picked up cleanly. Back row by Brown. Goes far side. Dew down. No tip there. 3-1. I thought they were going to call the tip. They didn't. 2-point lead for the home Tigers.
That right there is a classic case of throw my arms up and try and touch it. But thankfully I didn't. Because that's what just happened right there.
Edwards, right hand, and a tape kill ace for Edwards. 4-1. What a start for the Tigers.
Break out the tape because she's strapping them down. I don't know. I have no idea what that was.
That made no sense. But that's fine. That's fine. We're in Dupo. Everything's acceptable here. Edwards over the top of the net. Picked up right at the 10-foot line by Moffitt. Goes far side. Trying to get the angle kill was Ivy. Not able to get it. 5-1. The Comanches right now just really hurting themselves.
That they are. And they you saw it in the first game, too. They hurt themselves on simple mistakes, but Dupo wasn't able to capitalize.
Edwards serves over the top of the net. Picked up outside Dew. Sets back 10-foot line. Right hand over by Moffitt. Picked up cleanly, Hood goes far side. Right hand over is Amsden. Keeping alive with the right hand under punch there is Ivy. Not able to get there, but tip kill on that one. Kyle, we got our first tool of the second set.
How about some needle-nose pliers?
Needle-nose pliers. Right hand serve over the top of the net by Ivy. Quick back serve over the top, and Hood goes for the kill attempt, but it hits the tape. Goes far side. Moffitt goes for the kill, but Moffitt hits the top of the net, and it drops down 6-2 now. Still a 4-point lead for the home Tigers.
Yeah, Hood was going for the cross-corner shot, but she didn't get it, and luckily they with the return, and Moffitt just couldn't get it the tip to go. She hit it off the tape, and it dropped down in front of her.
Densmore over the top, picked up cleanly. there by 23 Grissom. Right hand over by Du on the set serve. Goes right side. Donald sends it over. Du picks up the set. Back set there by number two, Campbell. But mishitting it is Moffitt, and she sends it into the net 7-2.
Yeah, the one thing I'm really noticing from Moffitt is she uses a closed fist almost as if a punch that she uses to spike the ball over the top. You have no control over that.
Amsden sends it over the net, picked up cleanly far back corner by Brown. Sets up Du across the middle, but that one goes a bit out of bounds. Timeout now needed by the visiting Comanche. 6-point lead, 8-2 here on Sports Sound Chicago, where we are in a league of our own.
You may think that performance-enhancing drugs can help you hit the ball harder, help you throw the ball farther, make you bigger, stronger, faster, and more attractive to scouts. But performance-enhancing drugs won't make you a champion. To do that, you have to challenge yourself. At the Illinois High School Association, we're committed to making sure that today's high school athletes understand the dangers of using performance-enhancing drugs. This message is brought to you by the Illinois High School Association, inviting student-athletes, parents, and fans alike to challenge yourself and help bring out the best in our high schools and communities.
You're listening to the home of Fight Club Chicago, To the Whistle, 4th and Flacco, the Lamplighter's coverage of the Chicago Wolves, and Illinois High School Sports, SportsTownChicago.com. It is in a league of our own.
With an 8-2 lead, Amsden sends it over the net, picked up cleanly right hand, and Joust play there, Joust won by Hood, 9-2.
Once again, she's showing what she's capable of at the net, and that's why she likes playing that middle. And she said that was her favorite spot, so she's playing it to her full potential.
Amsden serves over. Moffitt, two-hand set to keep it back on the side of the home Tigers. Back set by Du. She tries to dump it with a back dump. Picked up cleanly by Ragsdale. Good bump to the near side. Moffitt goes over the two-hand set. Miscommunication there. And not able to get underneath it there is number 8, Kirsten Wilson, 9-3, your score. Again, two players going for it at the same time, and they were just looking at each other. You can't be doing that.
Once again, the communication thing is what's really getting them right now. And if they don't fix that, they're in a world of trouble. But you see when they do communicate, everything's fine.
Hall checks into the game. Good set serve. Edwards goes on. We have net play there. Du keeps it alive. Sends it over to 23 Grissom. Hood sends it up to the left hand. Ragsdale trying to keep it alive. Uppercut there. Two hand over to the top is by Campbell. Ragsdale sets up Hood. Hood down! Hook kill! Hook kill! I throw my hands up in the air sometimes saying,
I'm so Hood.
10-3 your score. Thank you for catching that. Thank you.
Hey, I know my rap music.
Ayo, gotta let go. 10-3 your score. Back to serve now is going to be number 4, Sissy Brown. Able to clear the net, picked up cleanly. Moffitt goes near side. Du down, off the tape. Du kill. Here I am, rock you.
Like a hurricane.
Thank you. 10-4. I'm going to see if you can pick up all these as I, you know, pick up what I put down or
Put down what I pick up.
There you go. Du with a misplayed serve, 11-4, and a service error. Again, let it be noted, Du, one of the standout players for the Comanches, also wearing a massive right knee brace.
Yeah, she started limping a little bit after one of the plays, so something obviously happened earlier in the season or previous in her career.
And spin around, jump up and down. We got an ace for Hood, 12-4 lead for the Tigers.
This is what you need. You need to be able to get out in front, and they're doing it right now. The errors aren't hurting them.
And Hood misplays the serve there. 12-5 is your score. Back to serve now is going to be number 28, Densimore. Waiting for the okay.
I think her dad just yelled at her from the crowd.
Right hand, set serve, clears the net. Picked up by Edwards on the near side. Joust, Brown wins that one. Tip, not able to tip it over the top. Two players running into each other as Campbell is kneed in the head by Ivy, but she is up quickly and okay. 13-5. Back to serve now is going to be the 5'7 senior, Kate Donald.
I still find it crazy that volleyball is one of the most concussion-filled sports in Illinois, or in high school, I should say.
You want more information on that, go to our website, sportstownchicago.com. We attended a concussion seminar at Northwestern University and got to interview some of the top athletic trainers who I actually saw yesterday or Saturday looking at the quarterback for Northwestern because I, you know, he's the head trainer for the team. Anyway, 13-6 your scores. We had a service error saying it out of bounds there. It was Donald and clear to the near side. Sets up Dew with a two-hand set over the top. Not able to play it. Edwards called with a lift. 13-7. The Comanches fighting back.
Once again, it hits off the tape right there, and she didn't know whether to bump it or set it, and so she was called for the lift right there, but it was more of a self-preservation shot right there.
Back to serve now. Right hand is number 13 by Hall, able to clear the net. Picked up. Sissy Brown goes back row. Donald right hand over the top. Brown able to pick that one up cleanly. Goes far side to Ivy. Ivy not able to get it over. Off the tip there. 14-7. 7-point lead for the Tigers. We have a substitution as checking out of the game is number 13, Ty Hall. And checking in is going to be Demetrius Brown.
Yeah, Ivy right there. She just mistimed the jump on the set and fell right behind her.
Back to serve now is going to be number 11 senior leader Kelsey Ragsdale. Able to clear the net there. Sends it back to the far side of the Tigers. Miscommunication again. Brooke Borden, who recently checked into the game for the Tigers, hitting another player while they were both going for the bump, 14-8.
That's something that you just got to work out with these the younger girls on the team.
I work out. Ragsdale sends it up to the near side. Right hand into the net there by Kirsten Wilson. 14-9, only a 5-point deficit.
Got a little antsy right there. Didn't know whether she wanted a standstill set over the top or if she wanted to jump set it over. But, you know, just got to figure that out before you actually do it.
Campbell back set. Serve clears net. Directional there. Picked up cleanly that time by Wilson. Net play there. Edwards loses the battle to 17. Moffitt 14-10. Timeout called by the home Dupo Tigers after having an 8-point lead. It's cut in half, 14-10. We'll be back. SportsTownChicago.com.
SportsTownChicago.com is now bringing you behind the scenes with contestants from NBC's The Biggest Loser.
Holy cow!
Check out SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser to download exclusive interviews with past contestants and winners.
Why are we so blessed?
Listen as they talk dieting, sports, hobbies, and life after The Biggest Loser. So log on to SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser now.
God bless the internet.
SportsTownChicago.com
in a league of our own.
If you rack them up, we'll cover the breaks on SportsTownChicago.com.
Over the top by Essie, and we are back underway. Right hand cleared. Good dig down low. Almost two Comanches running into each other. Directional set there by Dew. Right hand over the top by Wilson. Sets up near side for the Comanches. Dew over the top. Good pickup there by Donald off the ceiling. Right hand. Wilson not able to get it as she hits it into the top tape, and it falls back to her side. Down to a 3-point lead for the Tigers. The Comanches trailed by a lot, Kyle, but kept their composure.
They were down by 8 at one point, and this just goes to show you the strength of a team and being able to be consistent and come back.
Donald sends it over the net. A left-hand uppercut attempt there by Densimore. Not able to get that. 15-11 could be the break that the home Tigers needed with Edwards back to serve.
I didn't know if she was didn't know if it was going out of bounds or not, so she kind of took a swing at it, but that was an awkward arm movement, which was kind of followed by an awkward ball fall.
Right hand over by Edwards, who's one of the better servers on the team. Picked up cleanly far side Ragsdale. Quick set over the middle to Hood. Picked up in the 10-foot line there by Brown. Two-hand set over the top of the net there by 35 Ivy. Net play. Picked up cleanly. Dew. Set far side back to Dew. Right hand down. And Edwards not able to get underneath it. Dew. Kill. Baby, baby, baby. Oh, thought you'd always be mine. Be mine. 15-12. Yes, I quoted Bieber.
No words.
No words. Ivy able to clear the net on a good serve. Hood goes near side, sets up back to Hood, who tips it over the top, goes back on the near side. Dew takes a right hand underneath it, but picked up there by Wilson. Wilson right hand able to clear the net. Dew with a two-hand set. Back up to Dew, who does a reverse bump. Able to smile through that one. That's always fun to see. Hood with a two-hand set against Dew, able to clean it up there. Dew, Hood, battle, able to be won there, tips off the hands. Dump attempt there by Ragsdale. Sets to the near side for Moffitt. Moffitt down, Edwards picks it up from the back row. Sets up near side, reverse by Hood, able to keep it alive. Sets up for Brown. Brown goes up, Dew goes for the two-hand set, back to Hood. They're still playing, right-hand attempt by Ragsdale. Back, right-hand there by Campbell. Picked up back row, Donald. Goes near side, Hood two-hand set over the top. Two-hand bump there by Ivy. Two-hand side bump, and dropping right in front of Hood. Not one player for either team went for a massive kill. It was all almost allowing the other team to try to make a mistake. As checking into the game now is going to be number 23, Grissom. But interesting, one of the most interesting rallies I may have ever seen.
Yeah, all back bumps and really no kill attempts or anything like that. So it's definitely one of the most interesting I've ever seen in my six-week career.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding.
Moffitt with a service error and 16-13 your score. Back to serve now. After a substitution, checking in now is going to be Hall. And back to serve, number 28, Sierra Amsden, with a three-point lead for the home Tiger. Amsden over the net with the right hand. Two-hand set there by Densimore. Sets over to Dew, who sends it far. Dew with the directional. Dew's been bringing the power all day, but right now showing a lot more finesse. Kyle, they're only trailing by two.
It's one of those things when you're a good player in a conference, you can attack people's weaknesses with that and with the finesse game.
Jump serve by Dew. Beautiful jump serve. Goes far side with the set. Back sets again. Falling out of bounds, but not able to keep it in. Give some credit to Hall. I mean, she was literally falling backwards, but still able to at least clear the net on that one, 17-14.
That she was. She was definitely falling backwards, but it's really surprising that Cahokia really isn't attacking the one visual weakness you can see for Dupo, and that's their height. And Cahokia's inches taller, and it's very visual, and I'm surprised they're not attacking that.
Brown able to set it up to the near side. Dew two-hand side bump, but she sends it a bit too far as Ostertag checks into the game and able to communicate with her team to get out of the way, 18-14.
Trying to directional side bump it and just sends it a little bit too far out of bounds.
Back to serve yet again. Sissy Brown clears net, picked up at the 10-foot line. Good dig. Dew two-hand set over, sends it back to Ostertag. Sets up is going to be Ragsdale. Quick set to the near side, right hand over the top is going to be by Densimore. Two-hand bump by Densimore again, sets up Dew. Dew, net play, she goes for the dump, that's going to be number two, Campbell. Sets up Hood, Hood goes for the kill. Two-hand set up in the air by Moffitt. Goes far side by Hall. Hall sets up, back attempt by Hood on the dump, not able to get it. And running into the net is Moffitt, 19-14, another long rally of all bumps.
That once again, and Hood was the only one that actually went for the kill attempt, but it was just a little bit too far of her reach.
And right-hand directional is going to be by Brown. Sets up across the middle. Dew goes for the kill attempt. Picked up by Ostertag along the back right corner. Right-hand clears it. It's going to be Ragsdale. Picked up in the air by Moffitt. Moffitt goes far side. Goes for the kill attempt there as Hall. It'll be picked up cleanly. Right-hand over the top by Ragsdale. Bump near side over the net. Two-hand side there by Campbell. Brown goes for the kill attempt. Goes to Donald. Hits some wires. Knocks down some stuff. 20-14, your score, and a timeout called as the Tigers get the kill on that one. We'll take that timeout with them. But really quickly, this game brought to you also by the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. If you're interested in going to college to be a radio or TV broadcaster in front of the camera, behind the camera, learning it all, consider the Illinois Center for Broadcasting. Go to beonair.com for more information or call 630-916-1700, the Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportsTownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportsTownChicago.com.
I'd like to welcome y'all to another class.
And we're back and getting the kill there right after the quick timeout. Apparently nobody wants to take even close to 30 seconds.
That was 23 seconds, Pete.
We couldn't even get our full timeout, but that's fine. 20-15, your score. as the home Tigers still have a five-point lead. But back to serve is going to be Densmore. Right hand, set serve, clears the net, goes back row, picked up cleanly. Ragsdale goes over to Donald, right hand over the top of the net, do able to do a side bump. Two-hand set into the net again is Moffitt. She's tried that quick step hit into the net as we have Burton checking into the game for the first time today. And checking out, again, is going to be number 17, Moffitt, 21-15.
Yeah, she keeps going for that quick one-step push over the top, but it's just not working.
Good dig down low by Densmore. She rolls around, sets up to the far side, spike down by Ragsdale. Ragsdale able to get the kill. See that girl. Watch that scene.
Digging the dancing queen.
Do-do-do-do-do-do. 22-15, we might be going to three if the Tigers can close out with three more points. We'll see if the Comanches can send it the other way as due with a two-hand directional set. Picked up back row by Amsden. Right hand over the top, Edwards, but Edwards sends it far. Good job by the Comanches not to take a stab at that one. 22-16, six-point deficit for the visiting Cahokia Comanches.
Dupo's height is one of their biggest deterrents in this game. If they were just a little bit taller, that things would be going their way, I believe.
Right hand over the top, cleaned there by Hall. Donald with a right hand of her own, sending it back to the other side. Hall sets up near side. Ivy, two-hand directional set, good dig down low. Amsden picked up back row, 10-foot line. It is going to be by Densmore. Dig down low, two-hand over the top by Brown. Sets up at the 10-foot line. Donald sends it over the net. Dew sets back near side. Dump attempt there by two. Campbell, but blocked by Donald. Friendship request.
Dina.
23-16, 2 points away from winning the set here on SportsOnChicago.com, where we are, as always, in a league of our own. Back to serve now is going to be number 10, Donald. Bounces a few times, waiting for the clearance. Right hand over the top, and Donald able to clear the net. Dew, two-hand bump from the back row. Sets far side. Spike down. Good spike there from Burton. We haven't seen that all day. And able to dump it over. One of the first dumps of the day by number 4, Sissy Brown.
Flush it down, because that was a huge dump.
Yes. We are now at set 2 point as right hand Donald over the top of the net. Side bump there by 28, Densmore. Burton goes for a kill attempt. Burton able to get the kill, is not able to dive underneath it. There is number 13, Brooke Borden. There, it's still not over.
Definitely not over, Pete, but and Cahokia just needs to expose Dupo's weaknesses, and that's, I believe, right now is the back line because there's no communication.
Right hand, serve over the top by Campbell. Picked up far side, Burton. Sissy Brown goes for the dump attempt, and double hit called on Brown, 24-18.
Definitely don't want this right now because Cahokia has the capabilities of coming back.
1 point away. But can they be stopped? We'll find out. As Campbell back to serve. Right hand serve over the top. Picked up down low. Is going to be by Borden. Sends it on the side of the Cahokias. Two hand side by Campbell. Clears it over the net. Right hand into the net there by Ragsdale. 24-19.
Mistakes. And this is what you do not want right now. And you don't want to let Cahokia back in because they will take advantage of it.
Right hand, serve, over the top, stays in bounds is Campbell. Net play there by Dew, but Ragsdale keeps it alive. Donald sends it over with a two-hand set. But taking a right-hand punch as it was approaching the net was Campbell. Point goes to the Dupo Tigers. Kyle, we wouldn't have it any other way. 25-19, we're going to three. We'll be back in three on SportsSoundChicago.com, where we are in a league of our own.
You love watching and talking about sports, so why not turn that passion into a career in sports broadcasting at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting?
Hi, I'm Matt Abaticola from Sports Radio 670, the Score, Chicago's number one sports talk station. I wouldn't be where I'm at today without the time that I spent at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
For more information, go to beonair.com/Chicago Sports or text Chicago Sports to 33239. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where sports broadcasting careers begin.
With football season finally around the corner.
That ain't true!
Yes, it is, and that's why you need the Sports Hump for your pigskin fix. Wednesdays from 10 to 1, Rick and Ian...
They like playing with each other.
Well, that may be true, but they will break down the thoughts of the brightest minds in the game.
Playoffs? Don't talk about playoffs.
I don't know anything.
It's Division I football! It's a...
cannot play with him, cannot win with him, cannot coach with him, can't do it.
Go off any of our geniusness.
So tune in to the Sports Hump, Wednesdays from 10 to 1 on SportsTownChicago.com.
SportsTownChicago.com, the only place where you can talk Pokemon with the Pokemaster. Bringing you all the pressing topics brought to you by SportsTownChicago.com.
Breaking down the world of hockey from high school to the pros, covering every NHL team and getting into the crease with all the news and controversies. Following the Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks and the AHL powerhouse Chicago Wolves, giving you the latest info on the AHL and providing you with our complete access to the Wolves. Throw down your gloves, remove that face shield, and score off with us on the Lamplighters. If you can't light the lamp, get back into the box. Lamplighters, every Wednesday from 5 to 7 with Chris Lobosco and Adam Osgood on SportsTownChicago.com.
SportsTownChicago.com.
Don't you like how I can manage to go from a hip-hop sweeper to a Miley Cyrus song?
This is all so crazy. Everybody's get famous. My tummy's hurting and feeling kind of homesick. So much pressure in my nerves.
Edward's back to serve now. We are in SportsTownChicago.com. We have too much fun with our jobs, folks. Never have fun with your job. Right hand sending it too far for the Comanches. Number 17 on that one is going to be Moffitt. And 1-0 is your score. And Edwards is all smiles as the Home Tigers are winning. The Comanches were quite favored coming into this one. Edwards, right hand, serve over the top, picked up back row, is going to be by 6 Brown. Goes near side, two-hand direction by Ragsdale. Sets up cleanly, right side, spike down, good pickup back row, Donald. Ragsdale sends it back in for Hood with a two-arm side bump. Sets up to the near side, two-hand over the top on a directional set is Ivy. Armsdale able to send it over there. Keeping it alive on the far side is going to be Densimore. Right-hand tip. Again, Amsden sends it far side. Do able to get underneath it. Right-hand redirection there. Good play there by Moffitt. The directional hits finally work 1-1.
That they do. They definitely work that time. And just kind of going back and forth with the directional hits. And it just falls into a soft spot in the coverage for Dupo.
Back to serve now is going to be number 2, Campbell. Clear. Oh, does not clear the net. Service error on that one, 2-1. Dupo leads in the third set.
You just got to take advantage of these opportunities that you've been given right now and keep going.
Amsden back to serve now. Right hand, set serve. Clears the net, picked up. Back row, Densimore. Goes to the near side, do with the directional set. Able to get underneath it is Ragsdale. Campbell goes back across the middle. Block there by Donald. Good block there. Who is your daddy?
And what does he do?
3-1, your score. Dupo takes the two-point lead. Bouncing a few times again is going to be Amsden. Right hand, set, serve. Good hit, able to clear the net. Moffitt goes far side to Du. Du down, Du kill. And in the morning, I'm making waffles. 3-2, your score.
Waffles. Sounds tasty right now. I could go for breakfast right now.
We should find breakfast. Well, we still got sandwiches.
Oh, we do. Thank you, Mama Griff.
Yeah, we got sandwiches to take us through to get to where we're going next as Hood sends it a bit too far. Oh, Hood! Hood keeps it in! I'm your Huckleberry 4-2.
Oh, the echo in this room is awesome. Oh, I'm chuckling. This is awesome.
Back to serve is going to be Sissy Brown. Where have these kill calls been all day? You know?
I don't know.
Apparently everybody stops talking when I decide to talk. Hood down! Another kill! My name is Enigmo Montoya. You killed my father. Prepare to die. 5-2. Everybody's getting quiet.
I know. They're waiting to hear your next call.
Service error there on number 4, Sissy Brown. 5-3 your score. I feel it. Am I flushing?
Yeah, I definitely am. This is awesome.
5-3 your score.
They literally were. Every time the play stops, they listen for you.
The team is turning to like, look now. Moffitt serves it. Into the net. Service error there. 6-3 your score. 3-point lead. Let's try to get some composure here and try to finish things out.
We will finish things out here. But just got to capitalize on these mistakes.
Hood back to serve. Right hand. Good serve. Clears the net. Goes out of bounds. It took a second there. Coach Jenna Kramer not too happy with that call. So both officials looked at each other like, oh.
I don't know.
But 6-4 your score as Michaela Dew back to serve. Huge jump serve. One of the best, probably the best serve we've seen on the court today. Ragsdale goes far side, saying it out of bounds. Point goes to the Tigers. 7-4. Tigers, something must have happened in between that first and second set. Coach Kramer and Carpenter must have said something. They are really putting it to them right now. Comanche's not able to make the proper adjustments. Back to serve. Donald, right hand, clears the net. Dew, two-hand bump from the back row. Goes near side, Hall, able to clear the net. Picked up back row there by Borden. Right hand over the top. Does it stay in bounds? It stays in bounds for Amsden. Party rocking in the house tonight. 8-4.
Yeah, man. That's what you need. Expose their defense.
Donald over the top of the net. Sets up near side. Going over to Campbell. Right hand tip. Amsden able to pick it up. Going for the dump attempt is Edwards. Dew back attempt. Picked up cleanly at the 10-foot line is going to be by Borden. Not able to get in underneath it. Kill there. Point goes to the home Tigers. 9-4. We got a 5-point lead. Shot through the heart and you're to blame. You give love a bad name. 9-4. Donald serves over to the top of the net. Picked up back row. Grissom goes far side. Hall goes for the kill attempt. Is it tip? Wasn't tip. Point goes to Dupont. They're up to 10-4.
Yeah, this is what you need right now. You need to get out to a lead. And you really are exposing Cahokia, who I think is underestimated, Dupo.
Donald, right hand, set serve over the net. Picked up 10-foot line. Burton goes far side. Spike down. Two hands underneath by Ragsdale. Good dig by Sissy Brown. Goes far side by Burton. Tips over the top. Edwards not able to get underneath it. Point goes there to the visiting Comanches. Lead now 5 points.
Yeah, once again right there. They go for that little tip over the top, and they're expecting the powerful kills, and it's really throwing them off their game right now.
Back to serve is going to be number 28, Densmore. Densmore, right-hand serve. Edwards picks it up to the near back corner. Sets up to the near side, and Ragsdale sends it over, but Ragsdale with the side bump sends it too far. 10-6, only a 4-point lead now for the Tigers.
Yeah, a little bit too much muscle behind that one, but once again, you're just going for that back line because Koki is being sucked in.
And misplay on the return there is number 13, Brooke Borden, the 5'6 sophomore, lead dwindling only at 3.
Yeah, you don't want to let Cahokia back in it right now because just like you saw last time, you get back and then you have to fight. You have to keep fighting.
10-7 your score. Again, we're on SportsOnChicago.com in a league of our own. The Go South Sports Series, this game, if you're listening live, will be podcasted. Interviews will be available probably tomorrow.
They will be available tomorrow.
We'll be available tomorrow. We'll just say it now, so download this game. We got a lot of other games coming up. We're going to be at Hayworth tomorrow. We're going to be at Oakville High School in St. Louis on Wednesday. And on Thursday, the game of the week, Belleville East taking on the Edwardsville Tigers. That is going to be a slobber knocker. Densmore, and it goes out of bounds. Good communication there by Edwards and the home Tigers, not allowing that one to stay in bounds. 11-7.
Yeah, that definitely was good communication. You saw Edwards at the back line and saw where it was going and said, don't touch it. And that's what happens.
Ragsdale back to serve. Right hand, set serve. Able to get it over the net, picked up by Densmore. Side bump there, Campbell. Right hand over the top by Densmore. Not able to get there is Borden. Interesting thing to note, Kyle, with an 11-8 score, a lot of players in the game right now for the Tigers that haven't played together all game so far. A bit of a rotational issue, it seems.
Yeah, it seems like they've got a little bit of rotation. You have Hood, who's sitting out, and a couple other girls, but it's I think a thing where they're trying to get him in so they can get the experience playing together. And, you know, since they do have a little bit of a lead, and if you give up a point or two, it's not going to hurt you as bad.
Hall, a service error, 12-8 now. Back to serve is going to be Edwards. Edwards, number five, bounces a few times. Set serve, right hand. Good serve, clears the net, not able to play it there, is going to be number six, Brown. Clap, 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 stomp, stomp, spin, clap, clap, fist pump, ace.
Whoa. I love fist pumping. But, you know, right there, it's she's been your strongest server all night. Go to her as often as you can, and that's her third ace, so you need her.
Edwards, good ace attempt there, but picked up that time by Densmore. Back left row, Donald. Goes near side. Right hand over the top is going to be by Wilson. Oh, they're able to pick it up, but they send it out of bounds. Number 35 there is going to be Ivy. We're at 15-8. Slowly and surely, 14-8, this Tigers extending their lead again.
This is what they need. They got the rotation back to where they want it, and now they just need to put the pressure on.
Edwards clears the net, picked up, back row is going to be Brown, but they're not able to pass it cleanly to the net. Now at 15-8, got to be a timeout coming soon for the Comanches if this continues.
Absolutely need a timeout soon if this continues. You cannot let your team get down much more than this because at this point, it's tough to come back.
Edwards goes for yet another one. Oh, and they take a few stabs at it. It was going to the back corner. Miscommunication there, Edwards and Donald, but they still hold a 15-9 lead. Good job by Cahokia for getting underneath that one.
That one right there looked like it was going out of bounds, but once again, when it's going towards that back line, it's so tough to judge, so had to take a stab at it.
Teardrop serve over the top by Campbell. Sets it in the middle for Hood, who hits it with the left hand. Picked up back row there. Good bump there by 28, Densmore. Densmore picks up again after a quick send over. Edwards goes to out of bounds. Edwards sets up Ragsdale. Ragsdale goes for the directional dump, not able to get it to fall in bounds, 15-10.
That was three in a row that she went for in that, and two of the first ones were returned, and this one just happened to go out of bounds.
Campbell sends it over the net with a good serve, sets up Hood. Hood down, able to be returned cleanly by Brown. Two-hand back by Du, who recently checks into the game. Donald sends it up to the net, and Ragsdale able to get it over with a two-hand back bump. Du, two-hand directional set, picked up by Donald, far back corner. Sets up far side, but sending out on the far side is going to be Wilson, 15-11. Again, the lead dwindling. Cahokia, great coaching. They're able to stay in this game.
Yeah, definitely great coaching, and just poor setting right now for Dupo.
Campbell back, Hood over to the near side. Amsden's able to clear the net. Sets up to the far side for Ivy. Ivy, directional set. Hood wasn't ready for it. Hood was readjusting for a kill zone attempt. 15-12, three-point lead only now. Cahokia is fighting back.
Just like I said, you don't want to let Cahokia get back in this because they have a very powerful team, and they will put a hurting.
S.E. Campbell, set serve. Able to clear the net. Picked up by Hood with a two-hand bump. Back to Hood, goes for the kill. Does it stay in bounds? No, it doesn't. Goes a bit far. Close call, 15-13. And there is a timeout there by Coach Kramer. We'll take it with him, folks. Don't go anywhere. Conclusion of set three here on SportstownChicago.com.
SportstownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportstownChicago.com or dial 630-916-1700.
Butt scratcher!
Now, Peter.
Butt scratcher!
Peter, now!
Butt scratcher!
Now!
Butt scratcher!
SportstownChicago.com doing the dirty work so you don't have to.
That beat's hitting us, so we're playing back.
Beating the beat here on SportsSoundChicago.com, League of Our Own, here at Dupo High School, home of the Tigers. Back to serve with the right hand over the top is Campbell. Picked up cleanly down low on one knee is going to be Hood. Decoy by Hood. First decoy of the night. Wilson goes far side. Picked up cleanly by Du. Du. Hood. Back to Du. Du off the block. Able to block cleanly Hood. Picked up cleanly there by Campbell. Up down is going to be by Amsden. The up down, that was a good call there, Pete. Goes back row to Donald. Sets up to Wilson. Wilson right hand kill attempt. Densmore gets it from the back row. Two hand set there by Amsden. Under punch there by Amsden again. Donald sets up. Going to be to Ragsdale. To Wilson. Wilson down. Two players running into each other there. Going far side. Do a directional there. Ragsdale able to send it over to Amsden. Back row. Two hand bump by Brown. Sets up. Do down. Stays in bounds by Densmore. Donald sends it over the net. Miscommunication there by Dew and Ivy. 16-13. What a long rally as the one, the only, the Oster tag checks into the game for Edwards.
Great rally back and forth, but, you know, they go for the kills attempts and they just keep dumping it over the top. And I'm surprised that no one's really going for more kill attempts.
Amsden able to clear the net with a serve. Burton bump back row to Dew. Dew back set over the net. Donald sends it over the right hand, bumped by Brown at the 10-foot line. Hood sets up near side. Hood down. Hood with the kill. Get to the chopper. 17-13.
That right there is her game. Put it in a position where she can smack it down.
That was the first time I used that one. What did you think?
I like it.
Should I have used the accent?
You got to use the accent,
okay,
though.
Okay, next time I'll use the accent. Do not able to get into that one with the left hand, 18-13. 5-point lead for the DuPont Tigers.
They're putting it on right now, and this is the game that we've seen them play, and especially in the last set when they won. This is the game that they were playing.
Two hands set by Densmore from the back row. Dew sends it over the back bump. Ragsdale goes for the dump attempt. Underhand punch there by Burton. Good play there. Ragsdale sets up Donald. Donald blocked! Donald blocked by Ivy. Are you talking to me? 18-14.
And their height again for Cahokia is really a test for DuPont going up against it because they are shorter. So when they're going that, it's definitely tougher.
I want to point out really quickly, you are another person. Very few people in this world like myself say height. A lot of people say height.
I can't.
It's height.
Thank you.
That's how it's spelled. Back to serve now after our spelling bee is Grissom. Over the top, Hood. Densmore sends it back on the near side. Hood goes for the kill attempt. Hood with the kill! I see dead people! 19-14.
You must have great eyes.
It's like,
yeah, but no, going back to the height thing, my girlfriend says height, and I tell her she's wrong. She's crazy.
She's a bit crazy.
She's crazy.
Not able to pick it up is number 6, Brown. We are at 20-14 now. What a turn of events here from the first through third set. 6-point lead for the home Tigers.
Once again, they got the rotation back to where they wanted it.
Sissy Brown over the top to Burton. Back row. Somebody was able to get it over the net. About three players hit at the same time. Donald goes for the kill attempt. Jump set there by Dew. Back to Dew for the kill. Hits a light. Drops down. Light did not break. 20-15.
Thank God for the metal lights around it.
Wow.
That was a laser right at the lights.
And that's a high ceiling. This
isn't
one of those schools where there's a low ceiling. This is a fairly high ceiling.
That it is.
Burton, right hand, able to clear the net. And misplay bump on the return is going to be Ragsdale. Ace for Cahokia, 2016.
Just misplays and forced errors that are just really hurting them and allowing Cahokia to come back.
Burton, right hand, clears the net again. Picked up 1-1 action as Ostertag. Ostertag not able to cleanly pass it up. It is only a 3-point lead now for DuPont.
This is not what you want. You don't want to let them get back into this like that. It's really imperative.
Burton drops it in right before the back row. Ostertag goes to Brown. Donald sends it over with a side bump. Picked up by Dew. Dew to Burton. Donald sets up far side again. Sending it over with the right hand is going to be Ragsdale. Down low dig. Good dig there by Hall. Setting up on the near side. Donald again. Donald is blocked. Donald blocked by Ivy. 20-18. Timeout going to be taken on the court. As the lead has dwindled only to 2, we'll take that timeout with them here on SportstownChicago.com.
sports without the athletes, the fans, but it also wouldn't be high school sports without the officials. The IHSA is looking for officials in all sports. Officiating is a great way to stay involved with the sport you love. Above all, it's a great way to do something positive for your community. To learn how you can get involved and become a licensed IHSA official, call 309-663-6377. That's 309-663-6377. Or visit us on the web at IHSA.org. Stay in the game.
You are listening to the home of Fight Club Chicago.
Burton with a directional serve, picked up by Brown, right hand down, and kill there, I must break you, 21-18.
Oh, Ivan Drago, I was waiting for that one, it was only a matter of time.
I was saving it, I knew Hood had another good kill in her, I was holding off on that one. Back to serve, Hood, right hand over the top, Hall able to set it over. Donald, two-hand back bump. Bumps up to the near side is going to be for Burton. Due with a directional bump. Good dig back row by Burton. Sets it up to Brown. Edwards sends it over with a side bump. Densmore sets up to the far side. Due down over three players. Due down. Due kill. To quote Tron, end of line. 21-19.
Yeah, unfortunately right there, she went up for the block and caught it off the tip, and she really had no other... player behind her, they were just expecting to go down for it instead of the misdirection of the tip.
Due, good serve over the top, set to the far side by Edwards, sets back up to Edwards, who goes for the kill, two-hand set by Burton. Far side to Densmore, good dig there by Brown. Ragsdale sends it over the two-hand set, setting up the attack is going to be Due going for it again. Amsdale able to set it up to the far side, back to Donald. Donald, two-hand back bump. Set up far side there, Campbell, right-hand tip by Densmore. Sending it over is Edwards with a side bump. Campbell, back row, Due, over to Brown. Ragsdale, sending it over to Brown again. They're trying to set up a good attack, far side. Hall, over the top, Hall! What a smart play by Hall, 21-20, only a one-point deficit now for the visiting Comanches.
That definitely was a smart play. And probably one of the most aggressive attacks you saw all day. She went up and pretend like she was going for a full force attack, but tipped it right over.
Goes far side. Brown sets up to the back row by Due. She's able to keep it clearly. It's going to be Amsden. Amsden two. Oh, she goes for the set. Hits the tape. Drops down. Pull out the rope. We are tied up at 21.
This is unfortunate. Yeah, you had such a good lead. And you just let him crawl back in.
Due over the top. Amsdale able to cleanly pick it up from the back row. Donald over the top. Due runs into each other. Hood sets up to Brown. Back to the near side. Donald with a directional set. Due bump from the back row. Due goes for a kill attempt. Amsdale able to set it from the back row. Due diving out of bounds keeps it in bounds. Sending up to Hall. She delivers it on an angle. What a comeback. 22-21. The Tigers trail now by one.
And once again, they put it in a position where they couldn't reach it, but Dupo letting them back in.
Sets, near side. Ragsdale clears the net, but picked up cleanly by Grissom. Due over the top of the net, and Hood not able to get there. 23-21, 2 points away from victory now, is going to be Cahokia.
Yeah, big swing right here. Cahokia has the power to do it, but just a mental lapse by Dupo.
Edwards, bump from the back row, back to Edwards, who goes for the kill attempt, and sending it, and a double hit call. Edwards able to get the kill. I want to rock and roll all night.
And party every day.
23-22, back to serve the senior, 5-7, Kate Donald. Donald waiting for the call from the official. Some of the coaches for the Cahokia Comanches talking with the R2, and we have now gotten the clearance. Donald, right hand, serve over the net, and they call it out of bounds. Service error, 24-22. Checking into the game is going to be Ivy. What a turn of events here. Serve over the top, Densmore to Edwards. Back two hand by Sissy Brown. Edwards goes for the kill. Lift called. Edwards sends it over. 24-23. Back to serve. Well, checking into the game is going to be number 8, Wilson. But back to serve. Game on the line. No pressure here. Kelsey Ragsdale. Bounces a few times. There is a moth that recently also checked into the game, it seems. Ragsdale. Right hand. Good job clearing the net. Picked up from the back row. Burton. Near side. Spike down, and Hood sends it out of bounds. Cahokia comes out on top in thrilling fashion, 25-23, Griff.
Wow, I mean, it's unfortunate because Dupo had their number tonight, and the mental mistakes that they had let Cahokia back in the game.
Yeah, you can only make so many mistakes, and without having that lead dwindle, we saw it right there. We're going to take a quick timeout when we come back. Post-game analysis here on SportstownChicago.com.
Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportstownChicago.com, Bailey and Banks host Fallout MMA, where you can hear them talk about the top female MMA fighters and follow the UFC very closely. Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportstownChicago.com, Fallout MMA, Bailey and Banks. Come check out the aftermath.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Lori Cease.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting has given me all the necessary tools and resources to take my personal dreams to become a radio DJ to the next level. Not only am I the program director of TheEdgeOnAir.com, where you can hear the greatest music you've never heard, but I am also an on-air talent at 96.7 The Eagle, Classic Rock that really rocks. Again, without ICB, none of this could have been possible. And I would like to accredit all my success because of my start here at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportstownChicago.com, the only place where you can talk Pokemon with the Pokemaster.
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch, and it's bringing me out the dark.
And we are back on SportsTownChicago.com and a League of Our Own. Dr. Pete alongside Kyle Griffin and our STC player of the game, number 3 for the visiting Cahokias, Michaela Du. Michaela, congratulations on the honor. Talk us through this game. You really took it in the first one, lost it a bit in the second, trailing by a lot in the third. How did you get this comeback?
If we decided that if we work as a team, we can get more done instead of playing like individually.
Now, there's a lot of players out here that play at a high level. You had the best jump serve of the day. You really had a lot of kill attempts out there. Where did you develop your skills?
I used to play for a club vertical in Missouri, and they taught me a lot of skills. And my middle school, I've been playing since the sixth grade.
Now, what did Coach tell you during the timeouts in the second set and in between the second and third set to get the team back ready and coming with a thrilling victory here today?
That if we don't work as a team, we won't win anything. And we have to move our feet and stop being lazy and depending on one another and have to do our own part.
Now, how do you as a leader show your leadership to the rest of your teammates?
Keep talking, because if I be down, everybody else will start slacking and losing focus. And if I keep everybody up, the team spirit goes up.
Now, you had a lot of fun cheers on the side. I know some of your teammates had them. What was one of the cheers that really gets you motivated?
We go all team. Woo!
That's a fun one. Now, before we let you go, two quick questions. One, any thoughts on playing in college?
Yes, of course. I want to take it to the next level.
Very cool. Any offers so far?
No, I'm going to be talking with Kentucky very soon.
Oh, very cool. Well, congrats on that. Before we let you go, final question we ask to all of our players of the game, what are the pregame rituals? for Michaela to do?
We talk as a team, and we just everybody says what they're going to do and how what they're going to improve on.
And you put on your socks a certain way, certain song you dance to or sing to or anything?
Nicki Minaj, Fly is okay. Our team song.
Yeah. All right. Well, there you go. Congratulations, Michaela Dew, our STC player of the game. All right, congratulations. Oh, there we go. There we go. We'll shake hands. All right, well, we'll come back with a more post-game analysis here on SportsTownChicago.com, where we are in a league of our own.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Lori Cease.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting has given me all the necessary tools and resources to take my personal dreams to become a radio DJ to the next level. Not only am I the program director of TheEdgeOnAir.com, where you can hear the greatest music you've never heard, but I am also an on-air talent at 96.7 The Eagle, classic rock that really rocks. Again, without ICB, none of this could have been possible. And I would like to accredit all my success because of my start here at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
Hey, it's your boy Johnny K. I'm here with my partner Patrick. Say hi, Patrick.
Hi, Patrick.
And don't forget to tune into us each week for the Sunday Sports Show.
Yes, that's every Saturday on Sports Town Chicago.
Whoa.
What?
No, Sunday.
I thought we were on Saturday.
No, man, Sunday Sports Show.
Oh, I guess I never thought of it that way.
Oh, anyway, don't forget to tune into us each Sunday from 10 a.m. to noon, the Sunday Sports Show, only on SportsTownChicago.com.
What are we going to do about football season?
Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportsTownChicago.com. Bailey and Banks host Fallout MMA, where you can hear them talk about the top female MMA fighters and follow the UFC very closely. Sunday, 3 to 5 on SportsTownChicago.com. Fallout MMA, Bailey and Banks. Come check out the aftermath.
SportsTownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportsTownChicago.com or dial 630-916-1700.
SportsTownChicago.com is now bringing you behind the scenes with contestants from NBC's The Biggest Loser.
Holy cow!
Check out SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser to download exclusive interviews with past contestants and winners.
Why are we so blessed?
Listen as they talk dieting, sports, hobbies, and life after The Biggest Loser. So log on to SportsTownChicago.com/Biggest Loser now.
God bless the internet.
SportsTownChicago.com, in a league of our own.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Jarrell Jernigan.
At ICB, the most important lesson that I learned was that you get what you put into it. The days that you're at school, you have class for only 4 hours, and that doesn't do any justice. You actually have to put forward the time, grab an internship. You can't learn anything unless you're actually there at a real station learning what goes on. I'm currently at Cumulus Broadcasting, currently part-timer, helping out with anything between promotions to production to even on-air at times. And I couldn't have done that without the help of ICB and without an internship from Cumulus Broadcasting, 97ZOK.
You just heard it firsthand, so now it's your turn. Call the Illinois Center for Broadcasting at 630-916-1700 to schedule a campus tour. That's 630-916-1700. Or visit beonair.com. That's beonair.com. The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, where broadcasting careers begin.
SportsTownChicago.com is the internet sports station that is located at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting in Lombard, Illinois. We offer you a chance, or should I say, an opportunity, to become an on-air personality, get invited to live sporting events, and we teach you how to interact with your listeners. Get the training you need to get in the broadcasting industry. Just go to SportsTownChicago.com or dial 630-916-1700. 416-1700.
Hello, Chicago!
SportstownChicago.com is now your home for the Chicago Mustangs.
I don't believe you. You must be lying.
No, just keep it tuned to SportstownChicago.com as the Mustangs try to rise to the top of the Mid-States Football League.
I want to go higher.
With hard-hitting action and big plays all over the field, the Chicago Mustangs are the perfect start to your football season.
Football!
Go to SportstownChicago.com/ShyMustangs for all the action.
Can't wait!
SportstownChicago.com. We're in a league of our own.
Breaking down the world of hockey from high school to the pros, covering every NHL team and getting into the crease with all the news and controversies. Following the Stanley Cup champion Chicago Blackhawks and the AHL powerhouse Chicago Wolves, giving you the latest info on the AHL and providing you with our complete access to the Wolves. Throw down your gloves, remove that face shield, and score off with us on the Lamplighters. If you can't light the lamp, get back into the box. Lamplighters, every Wednesday from 5 to 7 with Chris Lobosco and Adam Osgood on SportstownChicago.com.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting, with hands-on training and face-to-face industry networking, has helped launch several great broadcasting careers. Illinois Center for Broadcasting graduate Lori Cease.
The Illinois Center for Broadcasting has given me all the necessary tools and resources to take my personal dream to become a radio DJ to the next level. Not only am I the program director of TheEdgeOnAir.com, where you can hear the greatest music you've never heard.
Did you see it's called a strikeout? Interesting. Yeah. I'll try one more. Why not? Pretty easy.
Yeah. Oh, come on!
Strike out the competition on SportsTownChicago.com.
Beautiful, dirty, dirty, rich, rich, dirty, dirty, beautiful, dirty, rich.
We are back on SportsOnChicago.com, the Go South Sports Series. Dr. Pete alongside Kyle Griffin. I always got to throw the Twitter.
Yeah. K Griffin. Throw it out there.
Here now with head coach Jenna Kramer. Coach, Cahokia came in really favored in this game. You took them all the way to the brink to three. How did you motivate the troops to get them that far?
They were really pumped for this game tonight. This is one of their last home games. We don't have very many left. So they were really pumped to play tonight. Cahokia is kind of our rival. They're right over the levee. So they were really excited to play. And they came out guns a-blazing tonight. So it ended up being a really good game.
Now, you coach all three levels tonight. You have kind of a busy schedule. How do you personally keep the motivation and keep the energy throughout the whole evening?
That's something that we've struggled with, especially having three in one night, and this being our homecoming week. So the girls are working hard on all different aspects. So, but really, you know, keeping the girls here all three games, so keeping the freshmen here, keeping them pumped. Those were the freshman girls up on the stand that were cheering at the end of the game, and that really keeps that varsity girls motivated. So, because not always will we have a bunch of people on the stands that will be as loud. So it's really nice to have their teammates really have their back and really motivate them on the court.
Now, what are some of the different things that you will say to the girls that are the freshmen, and then you have the JV and then the seniors? How different?